Hello, wonderful person, this is Anton, and in today's video we're going to be talking a little bit about the history of space and briefly mention a very interesting project that actually created an artificial ring around our planet Earth. Anyway, welcome to What the Math. So we are actually in a simulation where there's a sphere of moons orbiting around Earth, and you know, what can possibly go wrong here? Well, let's actually find out. Yeah, things will not end so well for our Earth with this sphere around it. Today we're talking about a very unusual, very interesting project that basically was developed in the early 60s, 1960s, and placed an artificial ring around our planet Earth due to, well, actually quite a lot of scares from the Soviet Union and the potential attack by the Soviet Union. And basically it was supposed to protect the United States communication routes in order for the United States to be able to communicate with most of the other countries. Now let's actually just finish the simulation, just wait for everything to explode and land on planet Earth. And let's actually briefly talk about what actually happened. Now, this project had a very unusual origin, and it was actually known as Project West Fork because of the location where it was developed. But originally, it was actually known as Project Needles. And let me actually explain to you why. All right, yeah, Earth is obviously not doing so well here. Let's just go to a more realistic simulation where there's just Earth. So the year is essentially 1957, 1958. And the American scientists realized that if ever the Soviet Union, which was located right here, decides to cut off the communication between North America and Europe, for example, by cutting these really, really long cables that actually stretched all the way across and are usually underwater, but if they were to use their submarines to cut off those cables, there would be no way for them to communicate with their bases in Germany, with their bases in essentially anywhere, Turkey, Europe, and of course Asia as well. This was a very big concern for the United States, and they decided to develop a kind of basically communication system that would prevent any such attack from the Soviet Union in order for them to be able to communicate. Now, one of such projects was actually very unusual. One of such projects was known as Project Diana, and the purpose of that project was to actually try to find a way to reflect the radio communication from the surface of the moon and then send it back to Earth. This was actually theoretically possible, but it wasn't very effective. So Project Diana, that started in 1946, was actually abandoned pretty quickly. The other project that was known as Project Echo, and I've actually made a video about it a few years ago, basically created these very, very large metallic balloons that I'm going to actually try to launch here by placing a bunch of random asteroids in orbit around Earth. So it was supposed to launch these very large metallic balloons that would orbit in upper atmosphere, and they would essentially be used to reflect the communication from through the atmosphere and from one point to another. But unfortunately, this was not very effective, and these could actually be easily shut down as well. So this project was also kind of abandoned. And the balloons were kind of hard to maintain, they were difficult to make, and they were too large to basically be effective. So a new project had to be born, and eventually scientists realized that, well, you could actually try to create a kind of a metallic ring around our planet using these tiny, tiny copper wires, about 1.8 centimeters or about just under an inch long, to try to transmit communication in the frequency of about 8 gigahertz. Now, this is what they were thinking. They were thinking of creating a kind of a ring, and we're going to do this right now by placing these particles here, and we're going to just give them some mass. We're going to change their color to something that looks more copperish, basically something that looks more this way. And we're also going to place them at the distance of about 3,500-ish kilometers away from the surface of the planet, and we're basically just going to add them right now. So there's that copper ring. Now, let's just run the simulation and see how it works. And essentially, this was planned back in the early 60s. And in 1961, they actually launched the first spacecraft that was supposed to carry these little particles to the orbit of our planet, but unfortunately it didn't deploy correctly, and so it actually ended up throwing them off somewhere into the orbit. We still don't really know exactly where they went, and some of them got clumped together and created big chunks of space debris. And because of this accident, the Soviet newspaper called Pravda wrote an article saying USA, dirty space, and basically claimed that the United States is going to create a lot of junk in space because of this little accident, which was actually, to be honest, completely correct. They ended up creating these huge chunks of copper that still orbit somewhere in space and might one day cause some crazy collision between a satellite or even a spacecraft with people in it. Some of them are still tracked today. There's about a dozen that is tracked by the various projects on the surface of our planet. And they've been in orbit for quite a long time. But then in 1963, they had a second launch, and they were successful at placing these at a distance of about 3,500 kilometers, which is about maybe about 2,000 miles or so. It kind of looked like this. And it basically was supposed to stay there for several years and was eventually supposed to be blown away by the solar winds and return back to the surface of our planet. And most of them did, and most of them actually ended up right here in the North Pole or right there in the South Pole. And that's because I actually made this ring a little bit incorrectly. I need to correct my mistake. They were actually orbiting this way. This was known as a polar orbit, and this way you could always see the United States from one of these points, and basically you could always reflect your data. So you could almost always be able to reflect data somewhere else around the world. And essentially, the way that this would work is, let's say you're located right here, you send information into space, it reflects back through the clouds and through basically most of the atmosphere, and it would actually boost the signal quite dramatically, making it go all over the world. And this way you wouldn't have to rely on, for example, ionosphere, which is very unpredictable and can actually be disturbed by the various solar flares, and it happens quite a lot. And you wouldn't have to rely on cables that are underwater that can easily be cut by Soviet submarines. So this ring kind of solved some of the communication problems, but it was obviously not very efficient, and it obviously didn't really boost the signal just as much as they would that the Americans would hope it would. But most importantly, this created a huge problem with space junk. And eventually, in 1962, the Americans were actually able to launch their first modern communication satellite, known as Telstar, and this really made this whole thing very obsolete, and a lot of people probably felt pretty dumb launching all of this junk here, because you could now just launch a satellite, which we can totally do by placing just a random human-made satellite right there in orbit around our planet, and this is Telstar satellite that is going to be basically replacing this whole ring of copper and making communication so much easier. And as the American military realized that this was a much better solution, they basically started making more and more of these and forgot about the whole ring thing. But finally, the ring is still kind of there. Some of it is still there, still orbits around our planet, and some of it is actually still going to be causing problems with space junk sometime in the next few hundred years, because a lot of these particles haven't actually returned back to Earth yet. And what's really interesting, and I guess what's really unusual, is that this idea, the idea of having satellites in space and having transmission satellites in space, actually didn't come from the military. It came from a science fiction space writer, Arthur C. Clarke, famous for his 2001 Space Odyssey. And he basically came up with this idea that you could reuse and launch German V2 rockets and create this kind of a ring of rockets in geostationary orbit that would kind of look like this, and would essentially orbit around our planet in a geostationary orbit, always pointing to the same spot on the planet's surface. And it would essentially act as a kind of a retransmitter of radio waves from planet Earth. They wouldn't actually transmit things themselves. They would just reflect things from through various radio antenna that would be installed on them. And interestingly, this idea was later used to create the first actual satellite that did the transmission and would orbit around our planet. And then we realized we can also place them in geostationary orbit to make this even easier. So all of this started as a kind of a science fiction idea, as basically yet another science fiction idea that turned into real life. But of course, the idea for all of this communication stuff, the idea of having these particles orbit around planet and reflect radio waves, and of course, the fact that you even have a smartphone right now that can actually use satellites to call anyone on the planet Earth, all of this started with this unusual fear during the Cold War era, this unusual pursuit of the military to create better and stronger weapons. And things like moon bases and men on Mars and everything else in space all started as essentially military pursuits. So we have to remember that most of our achievements today, especially groundbreaking achievements, actually start with the fear of being destroyed by another nation, which is kind of unusual. Our species is really funny that way. And well, anyway, that's all I wanted to talk about in this video. I just wanted to show you this unusual artificial ring that was created around our planet Earth back in 1963. And that's kind of still there today. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you still haven't and share this video with someone who enjoys watching space videos. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Come back tomorrow to learn something else. Space out. And as always, bye-bye. And if you've watched this long, you might enjoy this little explosion that's coming up really soon. Let's see what happens to our ring if we explode planet Earth.